Thanks for joining us for this very special event. My name is Todd Mouton. I'm honored to be here with you along with the star of the show, a very special artist. Sonny Landreth has a pair of Grammy nominations. He's twice graced the cover of Guitar Player magazine. He's been featured at every edition of Eric Clapton's Crossroads Guitar Festival. And now he's here to share his songs and stories with us all. It's his first live gig in a while, and it's also something of an album release party. Sonny's 14th full-length recording, Blacktop Run, is available worldwide now. And if you haven't heard it yet, you'll get to check out live versions of several of its 10 tracks during this session. And that will undoubtedly make you want to get your very own copy and to set it up as a favorite on your favorite streaming services. So, hi, Sonny.
Hey, Todd. How you doing tonight?
Today, tomorrow. It's live. And
it's live, baby. It's live. Yeah, it's a real honor to be in the people's homes and tune in for us. So we're going to keep connected here. I've got some old songs and a couple of more recent ones, and we'll see what happens.
All right, where'd you like to get started?
Yeah, we got the old Blues Attack from 1981. Your baby ain't home. Poor boy, about to get a blues attack. Baby on the sly, sneaking behind your back. Yeah, you know you got trouble when you knock on the door. Another one slam at the back of the porch. Poor boy, about to get a blues attack. Baby on the sly now, sneaking behind your back. Here she comes.
Thank you.
roar of the crowd. Thanks, everybody, for joining us for this session. That's a song that goes way, way back, and actually, so does the next one. Sonny's picked out a couple of tunes. Take us into this set, and we're here to celebrate tonight Blacktop Run, a brand new record. And this next song sort of sets the stage for the title cut of the new record, which we'll get to hear in a bit. Key to the Highway, I guess that's one of the original. I don't even know if they even had Blacktop when that song was written, but it was about the same idea, I guess.
Yeah, the essence of direction. I've written a lot of road songs. I relate to it a lot. And I think also, too, it's, you know, people and their lives change, and it's all about moving on to the next. But this old song has been done by so many people, and pretty much all of my heroes have done it at one time or another. And so the first time I heard it when I was a kid, the thing that struck me was the chord changes were different than the typical blues song. You know, it caught my ear. And I sort of fell in love with it and been playing it ever since. The Big Bill Brunzi version. Thank you.
Heat of the Highway. And that one also goes to the first released full-length album by Sonny Landreth, which was titled Blues Attack, came out in 1981. And the first two songs of the set, as we sort of segue into some songs from the new album, Blacktop Run. And this is a brand new record. It's very diverse. It mixes acoustic and electric instruments, even on the same track. And it's got a few different songwriters, including, of course, Sonny Landreth. This next song features the work of Steve Kahn, longtime collaborator of yours, Sonny. And I guess what I would say about this song, I was thinking about it, it's rootsy, but it's also contemplative.
He would very much appreciate that.
If you're tuned in, Steve.
And he is. So we give a shout out to Steve. Yeah, I wanted to do a couple of his songs and got his blessing. And it's really cool because I've been playing them for so many years with him. So I got the chance to reinterpret it with our band. And we did an acoustic version of this next song. I call it his kind of his existential blues tune. This is called Don't Ask Me. It's a world full of beauty. It's a world full of pain. It's a strange little trip on a runaway train. Well, I hear the whistle. Explain, I don't know what I'm doing here. But I'm going to the river, buddy, so are you. This train don't stop and no one might as well enjoy the view. Well, I get the feeling, ain't nothing else we can do. Don't ask me to explain, I'll leave the details up to you. If you wanna, you can ride on a donkey's back, but you go into the river. That much I know is true. Don't ask me to explain, I'll leave the details up to you. So I'll meet you at the river, I know you'll be on time. We'll roll on down the canyon where the water tastes like wine. Quite a few real views. Don't ask me to explain, I'll leave the details up to you. Don't ask me to explain, I'll leave the details up to you. Leaving it up to you.
Life's great mysteries.
The many mysteries.
And the chat function is up and running over on the Signature Sounds Parlor Room Home Sessions page. Want to thank those great folks for putting this together. And we're seeing folks chime in from literally all over the place. We've got
Very cool.
A lot of folks checking in.
Man, look at all this.
And
all over the place.
So it's like playing a gig in many places at one time.
It is. It's kind of a dream come true for me. I've been on the road for 50 years, so it's kind of nice to drive 12 minutes from my driveway, which I should mention, the way I'm doing this is studio style. This is where I actually do a lot of overdubs on my albums. I'm here at Electric Como Land with Tony Daigle at the helm. It's his place. And we got Carl Fontenot doing all the video, so we'll give them a shout out. So this is kind of a little, you know, peek into my world. This is, I get set up like this, and we'll do tracks out of, say, Dockside Studio, my favorite big studio in the world. And Stephen Wishy Nails are awesome. I've been recording out there for many, many years, pretty much most of my albums, you know, we worked on out there. And so we'll do that, and I'll come here and overdub on tracks, or I'll start, you know, with an idea for a song. And then, you know, Tony and I'll start building them, and we'll go out there and big room, get the great drum sounds, and do that, and then come back here. So back and forth, you know, get the funky vibe here in the hood on Simcoe Street.
And if you folks are hearing, there's a little bit of percussion in the mix. We're able to use some really cool technology. In some of the shots, you can probably see there's a bass drum on the floor, and that's where a lot of the percussion loops are put together organically to build the tracks. So the very place the record was assembled is where it's now sort of being reassembled.
That's it, you know. And what's interesting is, like some of these old places, you start finding sounds in the rooms, you know, and Tony's brilliant at that. He'll come up with ideas, and Brian Dunyak, and they'll, you know, hit on things like this, you know, and you hear a percussive sound and go, hey, that's cool. So you make a loop with that, and it gives it a vibe. So that's kind of the idea, you know. I wanted to do it here and, you know, pro audio, kind of upgrade everything, you know.
And we may talk more about the guitars and the amps, but yeah, there's a, when we get to that part, we'll talk about that part. Before we leave, though, this instrument, I should definitely ask you. I'm sure folks are watching you at home. They may have seen you on the road with this. What is this you're playing?
Yeah, this is a Larry Pagriba resonator guitar. The reso guitars go way, way, way back. There's a whole history, and I'd like to do another one of these and feature, you know, different resonator guitars. But essentially, it has a cone on the inside of the body here, which I've exposed so I can get to the strings better. And it reflects the sound. It's kind of the forerunner to the electric guitar. So a lot of people over the years have, you know, had their take on it. Luthiers would build them, and I just love them. It's an incredible sound. Larry's up in Montana. And actually, the first time he came on the bus, it was probably back in 1995, we were playing in Boulder, Colorado. And, you know, my road manager came up and said, hey, there's a guy here that has a resonator guitar he wants you to look at. So that piqued my interest. And so Larry came on the bus, and he had one very much like this. And I fell in love with it. And then some years later, Bonnie Raitt got one. And then I saw her playing it. And I said, oh, that's it. I got to have one. So I gave him a shout some years back, and I used this on the live album we did, live at the ACA here in Lafayette. So it's cool. So that's kind of got a lot of history going, you know.
Well, cool, and we're next up is the title song to the new record, and we were talking earlier, you were saying that you've enjoyed being home. You spent so much of your life on the road, and Key to the Highway, there are a lot of songs that are blues songs about the road. Blacktop Run is kind of a good song about the road.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's like changes and you're going forward, you know. And I wanted it to be more of that vibe. And I actually wrote this song on the road. This is a newer tune. And what's really cool about that is you're living the experience, and it gives it more of a, you know, credibility to you. Sometimes you want to have lyrics that, you know, really reflect that moment. You try to capture that moment and build on it from there. So it's a road song, and it's all moving on up.
Blacktop at my back, baby. The wind's at my back, baby. Like a friend, I need to keep pushing me. The wind's at my back, baby. Headed down the road.
Blacktop Run, and pretty fun stuff. It's there's on the Signature Sounds page. We've got folks chiming in from all over the place. That's signaturesounds.com/home sessions. Heard from folks in Japan, the Netherlands, Ireland, France, Sweden.
Look at this, Vancouver, D.C., New York, Austin, Massachusetts.
And I'd like to thank our volunteer moderator in the chat. Steve Kahn is apparently kind of keeping a lot of folks straight on the details of when the record came out and stuff. So he's sort of like our, you're our co-host, I guess, Steve. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve.
And shout out also to Brian Brignac and Dave Ranson. Folks are wondering if they're going to pop up magically here. The electric guitars are coming out. There is a, there's a speaker cabinet down the hall, turned up pretty loud.
Yeah, so we're going to wake up the neighbors now. Take care. But yeah, we're going to be doing a lot more of this. Is my plan, and want to get the band on this with Dave and Brian too, and also Steve, you know. And I should say also that the parlor room, when we played there, was Cindy Cashdower and I. So we do a duet a couple of times a year, and so I want to do something with her too. And so we got a lot to look forward to. Oh man, let's see what we got. We're gonna go electrified now. I've done it with the acoustic all I can.
And this song, I think we were talking during the rehearsal. This is, you played with the great King of Zydeco, Clifton Chenier, and this one's called Zydeco Shuffle, and you were saying that, you know, even though maybe a six-string slide guitar is not the first thing you think of when you say the word Zydeco, that's something that's something that has sort of come together in your music over the years.
Yeah, when I think of guitar and Zydeco, I think of Little Buck Sennegal, and he's the cat. He was our guru, and but there's so many influences there, and I did have that opportunity to work with Cliff, and it was liking that to, if I'd been, you know, if I was raised in Chicago and Muddy Waters took me under his wing, that's what it's like for me here. And this tune, you know, actually I recorded it in Crowley, Louisiana, many years ago, and it had a couple of different guitar parts. So when I started doing promotional, things and runs, playing at record stores in the day and radio stations and the like, I had to kind of bring those parts together on one approach here. So that's what I've been doing ever since. That other guitar player didn't show up, so it's called Zydeco Shuffle.
Shuffle right there. And I tell you what, this is, you know, the folks at Signature Sounds in the Parlor Room, they've set this up across multiple Facebook pages. It's streaming on YouTube. And of course, back at signaturesounds.com, we're kind of monitoring the chat room. Steve Kahn says he is playing along, and we should, if only we could hear it, I think is something what, like he said. And
I wish I could hear him.
And also want to make sure we shout out, Louisiana is listening too, and shout out to Parks and Freetown. And,
right.
You know, we got, baby. it's just stacking up over here. We got
Freetown to Japan, we got Ireland, France, Sweden. Oh man, you gotta love this.
Yeah, so thanks, guys. And on Facebook, I was able to sort of just share it to my page and stuff. So, you know, spread it around. It's really fun. And Judy and Russ said it's like a free visit to Lafayette.
Ah, perfect.
And I got to say, if you are tuned in from outside of the local area, it's beautiful weather down here, and we've been having a heck of a spring. It's been a great time down here. And yes, we're at Electric Como Land, and very special thanks to Tony Daigle and Carl Fontenot for making this look and sound.
That's right.
So great. And so one of the cool things about playing in this format is that you get to really hear pure sound. The fade outs and the everything, it just can linger. And next up, you have picked out a track that doesn't get played live very much because it's kind of hard in a smoky bar and a loud shouting room.
I've done it like that before, and this is a better setting. Yeah, you hear it all the good, the bad, and the ugly. And I don't, you know, this piece goes so far back, I almost don't remember, but I actually started working on it at home, and it sort of went from there, the idea being more of a meditative piece, and I think that's probably why it translates better like this. But I've done it a lot. I've played a lot of workshops, and part of the instructional videos I've done at True Fire and like that hit on aspects of different techniques about it. And this is called Next of Kindred Spirit. Thank you.
Next of Kindred Spirit, Sonny Landreth coming to you live from Electric Como Land. I understand this is the first three-camera shoot on the Signature Sound site. A lot of love going out to the folks at Signature Sounds for putting this together. I want to thank you guys all for joining us. We got about half the set left, and there's a chat feature there. If you're not already up into that, please sign in. There's some fun stuff going on there. Folks are saying they should have worn their T-shirts. And there's even a little bit of a tipping contest going on. Folks are trying to out-contribute to support this this broadcast.
We'll have none of that.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's just, again, it's you know, you should have known. We were worried this was going to be a little too boring, but with your fans all around the world, and we've now, I mean, it just folks keep chiming in from all over the place.
I guess I don't know if people can see that board up there. We're kind of keeping track. Our own little, you know, funky GPS going on here. Pretty cool.
Yeah, it's amazing. And and folks are asking different questions. But yeah, as you can see on the screen, there are options to tip, and yeah, proceeds go to the artist as well as to the venue. And of course, touring has been quite disrupted. And I guess you were telling me yesterday that gigs just keep getting pushed.
Yeah, you know, we're just keeping an eye on it. We want to get back to it, and there's just nothing like getting out there and playing for folks, you know. There's that immediate connection, that, especially in smaller venues. I mean, we've done it all, you know, the larger venues, the smaller ones, the sheds outside and festivals, and I love it all, you know. So this is a way to do it, to keep connected. And but we're looking at all of that, and as soon as we can get back out there when it's safe to do it, we will. And so we're looking ahead.
Well, cool. And folks are also asking technical questions. They're wondering where the Dumble amplifier is.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'd like to say something about that. I don't have it with me tonight. I got my trusty old Demeter TGA-3. Jim Demeter built that for me back in 1989 when I was still on the road with John Hyatt and the Goners. And then I also have a little Comet 19 amp here. The guys in Baton Rouge, good friends of mine. But what I want to do is different types of, you know, home sessions like this, as they're calling it, and I would almost call it studio session for me, but, and I want to do a whole, you know, piece with a Dumble amp and just go through everything that I love about it and use different guitars, and so I have some different ideas for things. And, we'll do, I'd like to do an all-acoustic session, get the guys here, and with the band, and then all electric, and just different types of things like that. So I'm kind of excited about all that, and something different, you know, different way of doing it.
It's definitely great to get to hear and see you up close like this. And I think we just got Mexico on the line, and Oaxaca is the best sounding place watching us so far. It's like shout out to Oaxaca. And speaking of gear and technical questions, perfect timing. Another Steve Kahn song coming up, and kind of a new guitar tuning for this song,
and, which I'll go into right now.
this is also a fun change of pace. Like I said, we were planning this. You know, we thought, there's no audience. But again, Sonny Landreth fans, Louisiana folks, you guys are making this so much fun. This is great having all the chatter. And yeah, Sonny's tuning his own guitars for a change. That he doesn't usually tune them even after I do.
To be honest,
Native Stepson.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
I jumped.
You know,
sorry.
We'll stay on track. I'll go back. We'll get back to Steve here in a minute. But
I was staying on track. Apologies, folks. Like I said, it's a live show. You never know what's gonna happen. And I want to thank Tony Daigle for keeping us on track once again. And also shout out to Jason Russo for making all the social media stuff happen. And you know, there are a lot of folks involved. I see Brad Hunt on the chat. And, you know, hearts really go out to everyone in the music industry, venues, festivals, managers, agents. To have things suddenly stop is not just unexpected, but, you know, really difficult, I know, for a lot of folks. And
it's a tough time. So we just got to hang in there together and take it one day at a time, you know.
And if I could read my set list, I'd know that this next song, it connects back to a lyric about your personal migration to living south of I-10.
Yeah, this is called Native Stepson. And I recorded this I always think of 1995 because that's when we did the album out at Dockside. And it was kind of a pivotal piece, this instrumental, and it set the kind of set the pace for the rest of the album. We've been playing it ever since, so I guess that says something. All right, we're gonna rock it out here a little bit. I can hear y'all yelling at home, I know it. Thank you.
stepson right there coming to you live. Electric Como Land. And here with Sonny Landreth. You could write, I think, a whole new song just based on this chat feed. We got Australia, Georgia, Baton Rouge, and the Bywater all side all by right. side. All
right.
They say that music brings people together, and I think this would be a great example of folks connecting. A couple folks have mentioned that it's very comfortable on their couch or wherever they're watching this. And I think one way to show your appreciation, you can provide a digital cover charge, if you like, to help support this effort. Please, the instructions are on the screen. Feel free to tip and send more comments. This is really cool stuff. It's again, it's a brave new world in many ways. And to get us back to where we were going, to another Steve Kahn song, this one called Somebody's Gotta Make a Move. And Sonny, you've played on a lot of Steve's records. He's played on a lot of your records. You guys have known each other for decades. And yes, and this is, there's a new tuning involved in this song, so to speak.
Yeah, so it's really cool because I've been playing this song with Steve for many years. And when I decided to try to cover it and come up with a way to, you know, kind of reinterpret it, I remember this tuning I had. It's a minor tuning, and a minor seventh tuning. So it kind of gave it the vibe. And you can get it different ways, but this one. And I thought it really fit the piece, so trying to create a little more atmosphere with it. It's really fun to do. I love playing this song, and I think it could become a blues standard. I can hear a lot of people doing this song. They'll sing it a lot better than I will, but I'll give it my best. Somebody got to make a move, even if it's wrong.
God knows I might regret it, but I won't know.
Sonny Landreth, right here, Home Sessions, Parlor Room, Signature Sounds, live from Electric Como Land. We had a truck go by, or a car,
yes,
with some lot of low end. I don't know if you guys could hear the little boom truck that went by a minute ago over here on Simcoe Street. Can't reveal much more about our secret location, but this is where all the magic happens, and so many great records have been made here, and including many by tonight's featured artist, Sonny Landreth. And folks are checking in. I mean, it can't even keep up with this, you know, Kentucky, Hebron, Connecticut. We got Thousand Oaks, California in the house. And some folks are breaking out fine bottles of fine gulping wine. We've got all sorts of references. Somebody wants to know questions about pickups. They want to watch the Dumble episode. So hopefully this is the beginning of a lot more. There's a couple more tunes here tonight. And Sonny Landreth fans of the world, thanks for tuning in. This is some cool stuff.
Yeah, it's really fun. And I almost mentioned it earlier, but we're in the hood here. So we get the boom box going by. We get the all of that happening. And also, I'm kind of disappointed because we usually have to, you know, mix and work in between trains. Tony's got a thing for trains. He always moves his studio around. He's got to be next to a train track.
We'll be here for a few minutes. We might.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, it's not over with yet. And so we'll see. You know, get a little train mojo. Yeah.
And next track is one that's been around for quite a while. And speaking of the road, this is the one that leads you home.
It's called Back to Bayou Teche. And so here we are from Simcoe Street to Bayou Teche.
Back to Bayou Teche.
about time to go back to Bayou Teche. Live here with Sonny Landreth, Signature Sounds, The Parlor Room, Electric Como Land. Thanks again to Carl Fontenot for putting together this great three-camera shoot. Tony Daigle, we're getting lots of compliments on the audio stream and lots of fun stuff going on there. I want to thank everybody tuning in for supporting this, and the performance will be archived. You can check it out, and hopefully the beginning of many more connections like this. And to round out the set, Sonny's going to change guitars one more time and go back to a song from about 12 years ago from a record he did called From the Reach. This is a number that you wrote that's called Universe.
Yeah, actually, I'm going to try to do my best. So I'm going to go with headphones.
Full studio.
We talk full studio mode here. And what we've actually done, Tony put different tracks from the actual recording we did. So we have bass and drums. Thank you, Dave. Guys there. And this song kind of sums up what I would impart and thinking of folks at home and all that's going on in the world right now. And it's a song, it's a prayer for peace, also acceptance. This is called Universe. Can't sleep, flip, flop, and roll, 'cause I see too much when my eyes are closed. My mind's a haunted mansion full of talking walls, every ghost of a worry roaming the halls. I make a wish for peace, blow out the light, and bid the universe good night. More than a random act going round this space, still in the running of the human race. We have stardust in every atom we see, so we ain't so different, you and me. I make a wish for peace, blow out the light, and bid the universe good night. To all creation, the love and light, won't you help me and all my kindred spirits? Good night.